Ideally, before you go and take anything off and before you go and take the battery out, what you'll want to do is turn your petcock into the off position. Have the bike running and let it just drain itself out, burn off all the fuel out of the lines and stuff. Take your seat off, whether you have a rear seat here, you have to take that bolt off, plus these two, but I have just the solo seat on, so all it is I've already taken them out. 2 6-millimeter Allen wrench bolts that, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see. One goes there, one goes there. And as you can see on the Allen wrench, 6 millimeter. Once you get those two or three bolts out, your seat should just lift right off like that. Next up, you'll want to remove the two bolts for the gas tank. This one at the base of the tank is just a 12 millimeter. Second bolt is at the top of the tank here, just behind where your handlebars and stuff mount. It's an 8 mil. As you can see, I got my 8 millimeter there. Gonna want to grab yourself some old rags or microfiber cloths or whatever that you don't care about getting dirty. Just tuck them down here on top of your key. Just take a pair of needle nose, crimp that hose connector, take flathead screwdriver and try to. All right, so as you can see here, I did manage to get it pulled away a little bit. So I will hopefully slide that down. Got the fuel line off the petcock there. As you can see, there's two ridges that it kind of butts up against, which makes it a little more difficult to come off. Got one more hose to take off, and that's this vent hose up here. Most of the time it just slides off pretty easy, like so. Before you go and take your tank off, just set up a little area that you can set it down, not directly on the ground. This is how I prop the tank up. As you can see, I got a cloth there on both sides of the front. The back's propped up. And as you can see there, the petcock isn't on the ground.